chance moved or leaning, then it would be an indication the tribe needs to leave and they would go in that direction. These two poles are very, very meaningful for the tribe, almost very sacred. It's very ceremonial, very sacred, the idea of moving, because it was difficult to do. And it meant that the tribe was going to undergo a great deal of change. My thinking about these poles and how significant they are, I'd envision that they would have been carved out of wood. They would have been wrapped in rawhide to hold feathers, perhaps, or in this case, a medicine bag. Sacred, sacred thing, the medicine bag. I drew a great deal of inspiration thinking about the eagle feathers that are also very sacred in the tribe, and they are attached with the rawhide. I have inscribed at the base of each piece, Choctaw Siaoki, I am Choctaw. In the bronze, it is going to be a lasting, an everlasting medium. It will be with the tribe, placed here. It will stand forever, virtually.
They treat our kids like family, and they treat them like individual people with love.
My daughter, all she could do was come home and talk about her teacher and what they learned and how much fun they had.
Hello, ladies!
You can really tell when someone loves what they do and is passionate about teaching. I think that really stands out, and all of the staff here is great.
Ava runs up and down the hallways and gives everyone hugs, both arms around the neck. It's just, I know that she's happy just in the way she acts.
The Child Development Center has been in here for 10 years. It has been very interesting to see everything go up around us. It's very convenient to have everything close by for parents who are working at the casino or working at the headquarters to drop their children off, and we're right here if they want to come check in at lunch.
Lily works great with my schedule, with being able to arrive to work early and stay a little late if I need to. That's right down the road from me.
It's actually very central to my job and my husband's job, so I'm actually right next door. So that's nice, and the hours work perfect for us.
My son, he needs speech therapy. And before we were driving all the way to Oklahoma City, I found out about the speech therapist there at the Indian Clinic through the Head Start, and he has improved so much. Having everything that the Choctaw offer, that's amazing, especially when you have four kids. So
I've learned a lot from them. Like my daughter, she taught me how to count in Choctaw, which I never could before.
Just to be a part of this daycare and have the amazing facilities, the wellness center, the daycare, the hospital that we have, I think that she's gonna grow up to see all of this and to experience how much the Choctaws have provided such great, great things for our children. So she's gonna grow up to know and want to give as well as they have, I hope.
The community center is supposed to be used for any Choctaw member for anything that they need. Baby showers, weddings, funerals. birthdays, graduation parties. We have Choctaw U here. It's busy most every day of the week. The community center was originally thought of a place where the members could come and meet, but the seniors use it every week. So a lot of the seniors feel that it's a senior center, and a lot of people do call it the senior center.
Next is Brenda Wood. Is still the queen of ripping out stitches. She made her husband, Ted, a shirt.
We tend to be loners sometimes when we get elderly. It helps people get together who otherwise might be isolated in their homes. They get to meet new people and socialize, and that's just very important. This way, the bus can pick them up and bring them if they're unable. People come in wheelchairs. I'm proud to be a Choctaw and proud to be a part of the community center.
Well, I'm very proud. I've been able to watch the headquarters grow from day one, from the foundation up, and I'm very proud to see it finished. They have the advantage here for the quickness to come in and get their answers here or to get some help and direction here. It's a beautiful structure, and I'm just proud to know that that belongs to Choctaw Nation and that I am a member of the Choctaw Nation.
In the beginning of this program, we did what we call tailgating, where we loaded up the boxes, took them out on a truck, and then handed out food to our clients. Chief Batten felt that it was much better to give our tribal members the better feeling to be able to go shop for yourself rather than us handing you the food, you know, off of the back of a truck. Say someone comes into the headquarters to see another program. That program can say, hey, you realize right over across the way there, you're kind of struggling right now. There's a food distribution store. You may not have to buy quite so much because you can get it supplemented over at the food store. You know, prior to this, people might have to travel all over town to go to different programs to get help from different places, you know, but here now they can come to the headquarters and everything's, it doesn't sound like much to most of us, but a 30-mile trip, gas money, all that, means a lot to them, so rather than have to make two or three trips from home to another program, they're right here and they can do everything at once. It's one of the things that the nation does that, you know, really important to our tribal members, so it makes me proud to be Choctaw.
There's so much space, there's so much room for equipment that allows us to welcome in more members.
We have an indoor walking track. We've got a full court basketball gym.
A lot more people can fit in here, a lot more activity.
We went from roughly 11,000 square feet up to around 55,000 square feet. We were able to add three additional fitness studios.
We also have a kids zone, so you can have kids from 1 to 6. And we have kids' class downstairs.
There's more space to bring your family, get everyone really into the fitness environment.
We've expanded our main fitness room floor. We went from around 2,100 square feet up to about 7,000 for the different fitness equipment.
We provided a powerlifting station for the big boys that like to lift heavy weights.
We have the self-propelled treadmill. We also have the Stairmaster upstairs.
New technology, more classrooms.
If there's not an instructor, you're in here late at night, you can click on the screen, it'll throw it up on the TV, and you basically have an instructor to teach you a class right there.
Let's go, you got it. Push it. Push to ceiling.
Pretty much doubled our CrossFit space as well. We have the suspended running track on the second floor, which is a little over a tenth of a mile.
Much needed, especially in summertime.
Not only can you bring your stroller and walk your kids, I mean, that's a bonus. It brings everybody of all ages together.
We're open to any tribal member or CDIB card holder and their immediate family. We also extend memberships to military, law enforcement, any of the emergency services top personnel.
There you go. Good job, James.
Just come in and get at it. There's plenty of great counselors and fitness specialists here that can walk you through any piece of equipment and help you reach your goals. I mean, really, it's that easy.
You don't pay for the personal trainers, you don't pay for the classes. I mean, you can't find that else anywhere.
Having the Durant location makes it so much more easier. There's lots of more options here. In the clinic, we have audiology, dental, we have the eye clinic, we have specialty, we have employee health, family practice, pediatrics. Specialty clinic has, you know, cardiology, general surgeon, podiatry. We do ultrasounds here, MRIs, CTs.
We have everything that you need. You don't have to go here and then go to another place for, like, you know, your pharmacy, your, I mean, everything's all in one house, and it just makes it so much easier to come here as opposed to any place else. Doctors, the nurses are amazing. They're courteous. They take care of you in a timely manner. Radiology, I've been there several times doing MRIs, and it's state-of-the-art technology. The new lighting that they have there, and the music, and with the headphones up. It's something I've never experienced before.
Everything being together really does help. Tribal members beforehand, you know, if you had to explain where something was, you had to give different locations, but now it's in one that will help a lot with just tribal members being able to find it in general. I love my job. I'm very thankful. I'm 27 years old and worked for Choctaw Nation for 10 years, and I'm very proud of that.
Went to the headquarters, and I was walking around, and I was on the top floor, and I was just shaking my head. We have our own little city here. Just about everything that we need is right here. To see all these buildings and then to see the culture intertwine, and it makes me really proud to be a Choctaw. I mean, it doesn't compare to any other tribes. That I'm a little biased, but I'm pretty amazed and pretty proud of what we've done here, and we're going to continue to do.
There was a time when our tribe was not located in the southeastern part of the United States. When they would stay a place for a length of time, they would plant a pole in the ground in the evening. And in the morning, if that pole were still upright, they would stay where they were. But if it were by chance moved or leaning, then it would be an indication the tribe needs to leave and they would go in that direction. These two poles are very, very meaningful for the tribe, almost very sacred. It's very ceremonial, very sacred, the idea of moving, because it was difficult to do. And it meant that the tribe was going to undergo a great deal of change. My thinking about these poles and how significant they are, I'd envisioned that they would have been carved out of wood. They would have been wrapped in rawhide to hold feathers, perhaps, or in this case, a medicine bag. Sacred, sacred thing, the medicine bag. I drew a great deal of inspiration thinking about the eagle feathers that are also very sacred in the tribe, and they are attached with the rawhide. I have inscribed at the base of each piece, Choctaw Siaoki. I am Choctaw. In the bronze, it is going to be a lasting, an everlasting medium. It will be with the tribe, placed here. It will stand forever, virtually.
They treat our kids like family, and they treat them like individual people with love.
My daughter, all she could do was come home and talk about her teacher and what they learned and how much fun they had.
Hello, baby.
You can really tell when someone loves what they do and is passionate about teaching. I think that really stands out, and all of the staff here is great.
Ava runs up and down the hallways and gives everyone hugs, both arms around the neck. It's just, I know that she's happy just in the way she acts.
The Child Development Center has been in here for 10 years. It has been very interesting to see everything go up around us. It's very convenient to have everything close by for parents who are working at the casino or working at the headquarters to drop their children off, and we're right here if they want to come check in at lunch.
Lily works great with my schedule, with being able to arrive to work early and stay a little late if I need to. It's right down the road from me.
It's actually very central to my job and my husband's job, so I'm actually right next door. So that's nice, and the hours work perfect for us.
My son, he needs speech therapy. And before we were driving all the way to Oklahoma City, I found out about the speech therapist there at the Indian Clinic through the Head Start, and he has improved so much. Having everything that the Choctaw offer, that's amazing, especially when you have four kids. So,
I've learned a lot from them. Like my daughter, she taught me how to count in Choctaw, which I never could before.
Just to be a part of this daycare and have the amazing facilities, the wellness center, the daycare, the hospital that we have, I think that she's going to grow up to see all of this and to experience how much the Choctaws have provided such great, great things for our children. So she's going to grow up to know and want to give as well as they have, I hope.
The community center is supposed to be used for any Choctaw member for anything that they need. Baby showers, weddings, funerals, birthdays, graduation parties. We have Choctaw U here. It's busy most every day of the week. The community center.
fear. He is a liar.
There's a wrestling in my heart and my mind, a disturbance and a tension I cannot seem to drive. And if I'm honest, there's quite a bit of fear to sit here in this silence and really hear you. What will you ask of me? Will I listen to your voice when you speak?
As a SiriusXM listener, you have access to our library of exclusive live performances you can't hear anywhere else. Here's one now on The Message.
How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great. How great is our God? 'Cause you're the name above all names. You are worthy of all praise. And my heart
fear can overtake any of us, and in those moments, you've got a Father God that lets you run to Him just as though you were a child, right into His arms. It's comforting words on Ryan Stevenson's newest song, Child in Your Arms, here on The Message.
In the darkness of the night, monsters running through my mind. I don't have the strength to fight. I need you. Fear is pounding in my chest. I can barely take a breath. Wishing I could find some rest. I need you. When the night is long, there is a secret place where I know I
On Instagram lately. So we are too. The message. Follow us for a regular dose of encouragement. Encouragement. At SiriusXM, The Message.
I push, I pull, go back and forth, finding myself. Pounding on a locked door, I try to make it out alone without your help. But I know I never win this war. I can never be free without you. I can never be me.
Good morning. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is a very special day, and we are glad to have each and every one of you here. We want to welcome you to the Choctaw Nation Headquarters Grand Opening Celebration. And it is my honor and privilege to introduce to you the Assistant Chief of the Choctaw Nation. Would you please welcome Mr. Jack Austin Jr.
Thank you, Jody. Thank you, everyone. Well, holly toe. Oh, Chugma, that is great to hear. I tell you what. Well, good morning and welcome, everyone. It is so great to be here. I'm honored, and it's a great pleasure to welcome you today to the Choctaw Nation Headquarters Campus Grand Opening. It is so great to see all of you, and we're glad that you're here with us today. To open our meeting, I'd like to ask Councilman Jennifer Woods if she would come open us with a word of prayer.
Let's pray. Our Father God, we just thank you so much for this glorious day, Father, that you have given us and you have allowed us to come together, Lord, just to uplift your name and just to thank you for the many blessings that you have bestowed upon the Choctaw Nation, Father, with our leadership, with our guidance, Father, and for us always, Father God, for putting you first, Lord, that you have directed us, the growth that we have seen, Father, we just thank you so much. And we're just so thankful in our hearts, Lord, that we love each other, that we love our people, and that our chief, Lord Jesus, that he guides us, that you would strengthen him, our assistant chief, council, and all the people, Father, that this building, Lord Jesus, is going to help each and every tribal member that comes, wherever they come from, Father, that they can come here and get all the services that they need, that we know, Lord, with housing needs and food distribution needs or job employment needs, Father, that they can come right here and be treated, Father, the way that you want us to show others is the love, the servant leadership, Lord, that is with us from our leader on down, Lord. We just thank you so much that we're going to be able, Lord, to provide these services to so many, and we just give thanks and honor, Lord, as we know that all good things come from you, Father, and only you, and through your love and for us, Father, just to guide you, to guide us, Lord, and for us to continue to serve you, that we know that growth is not going to stop, that we're just going to continue to take care of our people. We give you the honor and the glory in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jennifer. And you're able to remain standing for the posting of our colors by our Choctaw Nation Color Guard. Thank you. You may be seated. Well, what a beautiful morning it is. And next we'll have the Lord's Prayer performed by three wonderful young ladies that's doing an outstanding job representing the Choctaw Nation. And right now it's my pleasure to introduce them from District 8, serving as Little Miss Choctaw Nation, Maya Thomas. From District 4, Junior Miss Choctaw Nation, Jade Cossey. From District 1, Miss Choctaw Nation, Brianna Jefferson. And singing the Lord's Prayer today is one of our very own employees and tribal member from right here in Durant, Mr. Scott Wesley.
Pinky, Netag is pipita. Ahikapi kashofi. Ahika kilikasofi. Anok palika is pilawilina. Nanok polo pithlako fichi. Chimai hapili chica his chiumpi holy topa yabili ya ha me.
Great job, ladies. Scott, appreciate that very much. Well, next I have the pleasure of introducing a wonderful group of Choctaws that will be singing some Choctaw hymns this morning. Would you please welcome from Broken Bow and Bethel area, District 2, Choctaw Singers.
First of all, we are honored to be here, and we're glad to be here. The reason why we're here, we won first place on our senior day. Besides, this is not our first year. We won this last 2 years, so this is our third year in a row. So we're glad to be here, and we appreciate. We're from Beth Broken Bow in Bethel, and you know, I hate to brag. So you know, but we got a good singers, and hopefully, you know, we'll continue singing. And glad to be here. Thank you.
Oh, my.
Give them a big round of applause. And one more? Awesome, good. That was a great job. Thank you, District 2. Appreciate that very much. Well, today is a wonderful day to celebrate the opening of this campus, but also it's a wonderful opportunity to honor and thank God for his many blessings on the great Choctaw Nation. And reading from Proverbs 29 and verse 18, it states, "Where there is no vision, the people perish, but he that keepeth the law, happy is he." You know, wisdom breaks barriers to small ideas. Vision also inspires hope and greater possibilities. The person I get to introduce right now certainly has no small vision for our tribe, but rather a vision of the Choctaw spirit of greater possibilities. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Chief Gary Batten.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Governor. Thank you. Thank you all very much for that. That is quite an honor, but halito. Welcome to the grand opening of the Choctaw Nation headquarters, our people's home. Let's give a big round of applause for our people's home. I want to make sure that everybody understands this is a home where the Choctaw spirit of faith, family, and culture will be lived out daily. A home where love, grace, and prayer will be found daily. A home where all of our family members, our tribal members, employees, and communities will always be welcome. A home where our beautiful history and cultural will be displayed with a hope for the future. And District 2, just thank you for highlighting that culture. Our princesses, everybody, color guard, thank you all so much for making this such a glorious day. Let's give them a big round of applause. You know, just to tell you a little bit about this this whole entire campus, the building behind us is almost 500,000 square feet, which will house all of our employees. We'll equip them with the best tools to do their job in a fun, creative, transparent, and accountable environment. Right now, we've been located in over 30 different locations through Durant. Now we're all located in one location, and it allows teamwork to abound and communication to flow freely, so that we can make decisions for our people. And that's the reason why we're here, is to serve our people. And it's always, for me, it's always about striving to always achieve the Choctaw spirit, which is being something greater than ourselves. And this is, I want to make sure that everybody understands that this is an investment in our Choctaw people, that this building is home to almost 1,000 employees that provide opportunities and growth and prosperity, 213 departments here located, 145 Choctaw programs for our tribal members to 221,000 tribal members, and also houses our business side that has 69 businesses in 9 different industries. It will also house our integrated services, which is IT, HR, finance, that supports all now 10,000 plus employees. But it takes a lot of people making this happen and come together. We've got a lot of great people here. And first of all, I want to say a lot of thanks to people, but first and foremost, I want to say thank you to God and to Jesus, our Savior. Amen. And today, my wife couldn't be here. Sometime duty calls. She had auditors coming in to review her 2 clinics, but I'm very fortunate that I have my son, David, that's with us here today. And matter of fact, this is a pretty exciting week for us. This is a historical day. This Saturday is also historical for us because he's getting married to Miss Taylor, and we're not losing a son. We're gaining a daughter-in-law. And that's my son, David Batten, here. If y'all would, give him a round of applause. Also, I've got Jeffrey, which is going to be turning 16 this next month. I'm glad to have him here, and Miss Kaylin as well, my granddaughter. If y'all would, let's give them a big round of applause. But I also want to tell you, this person here to my right is doing a wonderful job. I always say, as chief, it's easy because we get to listen to our tribal members. We get to listen to people in the community come up, hear all those ideas. I get to come back and say, Jack, let's implement those. And he gets to come up with the resources, the people, the dollars, and all those things to make it happen. And he's doing you a wonderful job. And that's our assistant chief, Mr. Jack Austin. Let's give him a big round of applause. And I think about this group of men and women here to my left. I thank you so much for the partnership that we have, the trust that you have, and the ability to stay focused on our tribal members and do what's best for our people. And they are doing a great job representing the Choctaw Nation. That's our tribal council here. Let's give them a huge round of applause. And of course, none of this could happen. Governor, I have to say, we've got the number one staff in the whole U.S. Let's give our staff a big round of applause here. And I saw the mayor earlier with the city of Durant, and I saw the city manager. I'm not for sure where they are, but they have been great to partner with us here to bring things. I always tell the story that years ago when we wanted to start the Choctaw, when we ratified our Constitution in 1983, the city of Durant was the one that wanted us here. Jerry, Mayor, and everybody, let's give the city of Durant a big round of applause for making that happen. And of course, here in front of me, we have our state legislators, and just thank you so much for being here, supporting us, working through the state, making sure we have a better Oklahoma. Thank you all so very much for what you do. Let's give them a big round of applause. We're also very fortunate we have Chris Binge, and he is the chief of staff for the governor. He's the tribal liaison, jack of all trades, I don't know what, but he is so great to work with and doing a great job for the state of Oklahoma. Mr. Chris Binge, let's give him a big round of applause. And Adrian Farrell, thank you so much. Most of you know this last year we were fortunate to go over to Ireland and to be recognized for what our tribal members did in giving the gift to the people of Ireland. Also, the Taoiseach, or the Prime Minister, came back here about 3 months ago. Adrian is the one that coordinated all of that, that made it happen. He lives in Austin, and Adrian, thank you so very much for being here today. Let's give him a big round of applause. And also, I say, you know, none of these things just happen instantly. It's because we've had great leadership. We've had great people in our lives. And I'm really kind of saddened that he's not here today, and that's our former Chief Pyle, but I'm honored at the same time to have Pat. his wife and his son, Eric, be here with us today. And thank you so much for what you have done for our tribe and for our nation. Let's give them a big round of applause. But like I was saying, you know, this campus, this is just the headquarters here. But also we have a wellness center here, almost 50,000 square feet facility that's to promote wellness for all of our tribal members and employees. We have our public safety division, which is our law enforcement entity of this that's located out on Big Lots Drive. We have our construction and maintenance just up the street. And I know the council gives this guy a hard time, but the community center, our District 9 community center, is right here so that our elders can have a place to eat and to congregate and come together. We have our Head Start daycare that's located here for our employees and for our tribal members as well. Our food distribution program is located here. We have our new clinic that's just located off to my right here. That's state of the art. And then before long, we're going to have our judicial building that's constructed, and we have our judges here with today. And judges, if you would, thank you so much for everything that you do for us and making us a strong, sovereign nation. Thank you. Let's give our judicial branch a big round of applause. But I say all those things to say all of this is possible because of our ancestors who had the Chota spirit of resiliency, strength, love and hope for a better day for our people. Today is that today. Today is a Chukma. It is a good day. Now it is our duty. You know, I look behind us. We have the pole here. And the pole, Janie Umstead called it a sacred vision. And so now it's our duty, it's our responsibility, it's our moral obligation to continue this wonderful journey that our Choctaw people have been on. Today is a good day. But we need to continue looking for the future and making a better day for our Choctaw people. So with that, I want to say hopefully that everybody today has felt that Chota spirit, all the tribal members, all the people of the community, all of our friends and everything. I hope today that you can say, Chota sia hoki. I am proud to be Choctaw. Thank you, and God bless each and every one of you. And I always say that I consider this an honor because I consider him a dear friend. I consider him a brother. I consider him a mentor. He's done so much for me, for my family, and the guidance and direction that he's done for me. And I appreciate him so much. And I'd like to have Governor Bill Anitubby come up and say a few words. Let's give Governor, our brother, a big round of applause.
Thank you, Chief. I, too, cherish that relationship with you, with the Choctaw people. We've had a close relationship for generations, and we continue to foster that. And congratulations to you and to the members of the council and the rest of the Choctaw people that are here and everywhere, really, on this new facility. It's absolutely magnificent, don't you think? And something that you mentioned earlier is about ancestors. You know, if our ancestors, your ancestors, could be here today and witness this, wouldn't they be proud? Wouldn't they be proud? They would, you know, they went through some pretty difficult times back in the early days, 1800s, when, well, the Trail of Tears moved our people, uprooted our people from our homeland and moved us into Indian territory, suck our roots deep again. And then here comes Oklahoma, right? Oklahoma became a state. And there was a real effort to do away with tribal government and to take our culture away, to take our language away, to take our traditions away. Wouldn't they be proud today to know that your motto or your byline is so deeply rooted in what is important to the Chickasaw people, faith, family, and culture. And you can look around here and you can see how committed you are to the Choctaw people. We've mentioned the building, but look around it. You mentioned the other buildings. Now that sends a statement to everyone, right? that Choctaw people hear come first, right? And that's important, because that is what this government is all about. That's what this administration is about. That's what the council is about. And so I congratulate you, Chief, and I congratulate all the Choctaw people, the council, on this magnificent building and this achievement. Thank you for inviting me.
As we get ready to continue this celebration, I want to introduce some other people, if you would. The Choctaw Nation Tribal Judges, if you guys would stand up. Also, our state senators, Lonnie Paxton, Greg McCourtney, I'm sorry. Our state representatives, Dustin Roberts and J.J. Humphreys. And from James Lankford's office, Senate office, Mona Taylor and Caleb Cochran. And from Senator Inhofe's office, Jared Ward. Okay, now we are ready to take the official picture. And so, if we want to get back here and do the ribbon cutting. Okay, all the dignitaries, if they would, walk over there. Now, I've got a whole list of announcements that I need to make. So as we go ahead and take the picture for the ribbon cutting, I want to be sure and tell everybody that tours are going to be available as soon as we do the official photo. And so you'll be able to go in, take a tour of the facility. Also, lunch is going to be provided in the conference center area. Photos can be taken with Chief and Assistant Chief. On the inside, there is a commemorative backdrop that is set up there in the rotunda. For the Choctaw seniors, your buses are going to pick you up exactly where you were dropped off this morning. And for those Choctaw seniors, there's a free buffet that's going to be in the Magnolia Room. And also, there is some beautiful Choctaw artwork that is in there in the front in the rotunda. So if you want to go in there and visit with those artists and look at all that, also there's going to be social dances in the rotunda as well. So as soon as they take that picture, anybody else that wants to go over there and be in the picture, you're certainly welcome to. And so with that being said, we'll let them take the picture. And that's going to conclude this portion of it. And then we're going to be able to go in there and have lunch. Ladies and gentlemen, thank each and every one of you for being here today. Let's put our hands together for all the great things that's going on with the Choctaw Nation. Thank you.
You're not alone. Oh, my soul, you're not redeemed, rising from the African plain. It's the song of the forgiven, drowning out the Amazon rain. The song of Asian believers, filled with God's holy fire. It's every tribe, every tongue, every nation, a love song born of a grateful choir. It's all God's children singing glory, glory. Hallelujah, He reigns, He reigns.
heavenly sound. Let praises echo from the towers of cathedrals to the faithful gathered underground. Of all the songs sung from the dawn of creation, some were meant to persist. Of all the bells rung from a thousand steeples, none rings truer than this.
There was a time when our tribe was not located in the southeastern part of the United States. When they would stay a place for a length of time, they would plant a pole in the ground in the evening. And in the morning, if that pole were still upright, they would stay where they were. But if it were by chance moved or leaning, then it would be an indication the tribe needed to leave and they would go in that direction. These two poles are very, very meaningful for the tribe, almost very sacred. It's very ceremonial, very sacred, the idea of moving, because it was difficult to do. And it meant that the tribe was going to undergo a great deal of change. My thinking about these poles and how significant they are, I'd envisioned that they would have been carved out of wood. They would have been wrapped in rawhide to hold feathers, perhaps, or in this case, medicine bag, sacred, sacred thing, the medicine bag. I drew a great deal of inspiration thinking about the eagle feathers that are also very sacred in the tribe, and they are attached with the rawhide. I have inscribed at the base of each piece, Choctaw Siaoki, I am Choctaw. In the bronze, it is going to be a lasting, an everlasting medium. It will be with the tribe, placed here, it will stand forever, virtually.
They treat our kids like family, and they treat them like individual people with love.
My daughter, all she could do was come home and talk about her teacher and what they learned and how much fun they had.
Hello, baby!
You can really tell when someone loves what they do and is passionate about teaching. I think that really stands out, and all of the staff here is great.
Ava runs up and down the hallways and gives everyone hugs, both arms around the neck. It's just, I know that she's happy just in the way she acts.
The Child Development Center has been in here for 10 years. It has been very interesting to see everything go up around us. It's very convenient to have everything close by for parents who are working at the casino or working at the headquarters to drop their children off, and we're right here if they want to come check in at lunch.
Lily works great with my schedule, with being able to arrive to work early and stay a little late if I need to. It's right down the road from me.
It's actually very central to my job and my husband's job, so I'm actually right next door. So that's nice, and the hours work perfect for us.
My son, he needs speech therapy. And before we were driving all the way to Oklahoma City, I found out about the speech therapist there at the Indian Clinic through the Head Start, and he has improved so much. Having everything that the Choctaw offer, that's amazing, especially when you have four kids. So,
I've learned a lot from them. Like my daughter, she taught me how to count in Choctaw, which I never could before.
Just to be a part of this daycare and have the amazing facilities, the wellness center, the daycare, the hospital that we have, I think that she's gonna grow up to see all of this and to experience how much the Choctaws have provided such great things for our children. So she's gonna grow up to know and want to give as well as they have, I hope.
The community center is supposed to be used for any Choctaw member for anything that they need. Baby showers, weddings, funerals, birthdays, graduation parties. We have Choctaw U here. It's busy most every day of the week. The community center was originally thought of a place where the members could come and meet, but the seniors use it every week. So a lot of the seniors feel that it's a senior center, and a lot of people do call it the senior center.
Next is Brenda Wood, is still the queen of ripping out stitches. She made her husband Ted a shirt.
We tend to be loners sometimes when we get elderly. It helps people get together who otherwise might be isolated in their homes. They get to meet new people and socialize, and that's just very important. This way the bus can pick them up and bring them if they're unable. People come in wheelchairs. I'm proud to be a Choctaw and proud to be a part of the community center.
Well, I'm very proud. I've been able to watch the headquarters grow from day one, from the foundation up, and I'm very proud to see it finished. They have the advantage here for the quickness to come in and get their answers here, or to get some help and direction here. It's a beautiful structure, and I'm just proud to know that that belongs to Choctaw Nation and that I am a member of the Choctaw Nation.
In the beginning of this program, we did what we call tailgating, where we loaded up the boxes, took them out on a truck, and then handed out food to our clients. Chief Batten felt that it was much better to give our tribal members a better feeling to be able to go shop for yourself rather than us handing you the food, you know, off of the back of a truck. Say someone comes into the headquarters to see another program, that program can say, hey, you realize right over across the way there, you're kind of struggling right now. There's a food distribution store. You may not have to buy quite so much because you get it supplemented over at the food store. You know, prior to this, people might have to travel all over town to go to different programs to get help from different places, you know, but here now they can come to the headquarters and everything's, it doesn't sound like much to most of us, but a 30-mile trip, gas money, all that, means a lot to them. So rather than have to make two or three trips from home to another program, they're right here and they can do everything at once. It's one of the things that the nation does that, you know, really important to our tribal members. So it makes me proud to be Choctaw.
There's so much space, there's so much room for equipment that allows us to welcome in more members.
Here we have an indoor walking track. We've got a full court basketball gym.
A lot more people can fit in here, a lot more activity.
We went from roughly 11,000 square feet up to around 55,000 square feet. We were able to add three additional fitness studios.
We also have a kids zone, so you can have kids from 1 to 6. And we have kids' class downstairs.
There's more space to bring your family, get everyone really into the fitness environment.
We've expanded our main fitness room floor. We went from around 2,100 square feet up to about 7,000 for the different fitness equipment.
We provided a powerlifting station for the big boys that like to lift heavy weights.
We have the self-propelled treadmill. We also have the Stairmaster upstairs.
New technology, more classrooms.
There's not an instructor, you're in here late at night. You can click on the screen, it'll throw it up on the TV, and you basically have an instructor to teach you a class right there.
Let's go, you got it. Push it. Push it, Dylan.
Pretty much doubled our CrossFit space as well. We have the suspended running track on the second floor, which is a little over a tenth of a mile.
Much needed, especially in summertime.
Not only can you bring your stroller and walk your kids, I mean, that's a bonus. It brings everybody of all ages together.
We're open to any tribal member or CDIB card holder and their immediate family. We also extend memberships to military, law enforcement, any of the emergency services top personnel.
There you go. Good job, James.
Just come in and get at it. There's plenty of great counselors and fitness specialists here that can walk you through any piece of equipment and help you reach your goals. I mean, really, it's that easy.
You don't pay for the personal trainers, you don't pay for the classes. I mean, you can't find that else anywhere.
Having the Durant location makes it so much more easier. There's lots of more options here. In the clinic, we have audiology, dental, we have the eye clinic, we have specialty, we have employee health, family practice, pediatrics. Specialty clinic has, you know, cardiology, general surgeon, podiatry. We do ultrasounds here, MRIs, CTs.
We have everything that you need. You don't have to go here and then go to another place for, like, you know, your pharmacy, your, I mean, everything's all in one house, and it just makes it so much easier to come here as opposed to any place else. Doctors, the nurses are amazing. They're courteous. They take care of you in a timely manner. Radiology, I've been there several times doing MRIs, and it's state-of-the-art technology. The new lighting that they have there, and the music, and the, with the headphones up, it's something I've never experienced before.
Everything being together really does help. Tribal members beforehand, you know, if you had to explain where something was, you had to give different locations, but now it's in one that will help a lot with just tribal members being able to find it in general. I love my job, I'm very thankful. I'm 27 years old and worked for Choctaw Nation for 10 years, and I'm very proud of that.
went to the headquarters and I was walking around and I was on the top floor and I was just shaking my head. We have our own little city here. Just about everything that we need is right here. To see all these buildings and then to see the culture intertwine, and it makes me really proud to be a Choctaw. I mean, it doesn't compare to any other tribes. That I'm a little biased, but I'm pretty amazed and pretty proud of what we've done here and we're going to continue to do.
There was a time when our tribe was not located in the southeastern part of the United States. When they would stay a place for a length of time, they would plant a pole in the ground in the evening. And in the morning, if that pole were still upright, they would stay where they were. But if it were by chance moved or leaning, then it would be an indication the tribe needed to leave and they would go in that direction. These two poles are very, very meaningful for the tribe, almost very sacred. It's very ceremonial, very sacred, the idea of moving, because it was difficult to do. And it meant that the tribe was going to undergo a great deal of change. My thinking about these poles and how significant they are, I'd envisioned that they would have been carved out of wood. They would have been wrapped in rawhide to hold feathers, perhaps, or in this case, medicine bag, sacred, sacred thing, the medicine bag. I drew a great deal of inspiration thinking about the eagle feathers that are also very sacred in the tribe, and they are attached with the rawhide. I have inscribed at the base of each piece, Choctaw Siaoki, I am Choctaw. In the bronze, it is going to be a lasting, an everlasting medium. It will be with the tribe, placed here, it will stand forever, virtually.
They treat our kids like family, and they treat them like individual people with love.
My daughter, all she could do was come home and talk about her teacher and what they learned and how much fun they had.
Hello, baby.
You can really tell when someone loves what they do and is passionate about teaching. I think that really stands out, and all of the staff here is great.
Ava runs up and down the hallways and gives everyone hugs, both arms around the neck. It's just, I know that she's happy just in the way she acts.
The Child Development Center has been in here for 10 years. It has been very interesting to see everything go up around us. It's very convenient to have everything close by for parents who are working at the casino or working at the headquarters to drop their children off, and we're right here if they want to come check in at lunch.
Lily works great with my schedule, with being able to arrive to work early and stay a little late if I need to. That's right down the road from me.
It's actually very central to my job and my husband's job, so I'm actually right next door. So that's nice, and the hours work perfect for us.
my son, he needs speech therapy. And before we were driving all the way to Oklahoma City, I found out about the speech therapist there at the Indian Clinic through the Head Start, and he has improved so much. Having everything that the Choctaw offer, that's amazing, especially when you have four kids, so.
I've learned a lot from them. Like my daughter, she taught me how to count in Choctaw, which I never could before.
Just to be a part of this daycare and have the amazing facilities, the wellness center, the daycare, the hospital that we have, I think that she's going to grow up to see all of this and to experience how much the Choctaws have provided such great things for our children. So she's going to grow up to know and want to give as well as they have, I hope.
The community center is supposed to be used for any Choctaw member for anything that they need. Baby showers, weddings, funerals, birthdays, graduation parties. We have Choctaw U here. It's busy most every day of the week. The community center was originally thought of a place where the members could come and meet, but the seniors use it every week. So a lot of the seniors feel that it's a senior center, and a lot of people do call it the senior center.
Next is Brenda Wood, is still the queen of ripping out stitches. She made her husband Ted a shirt.
We tend to be loners sometimes when we get elderly. It helps people get together who otherwise might be isolated in their homes. They get to meet new people and socialize, and that's just very important. This way, the bus can pick them up and bring them if they're unable. People come in wheelchairs. I'm proud to be a Choctaw and proud to be a part of the community center.
Well, I'm very proud. I've been able to watch the headquarters grow from day one, from the foundation up, and I'm very proud to see it finished. They have the advantage here for the quickness to come in and get their answers here, or to get some help and direction here. It's a beautiful structure, and I'm just proud to know that that belongs to Choctaw Nation and that I am a member of the Choctaw Nation.